Good afternoon, everyone. This Sunday is the Sunday of the Holy Trinity. We believe as Christians in the great mystery of one God, but three persons, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we worship Him, we adore Him. He is our magnificent God. In this Sunday, we start off with the first reading, Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 32 to 34, and then 39 to 40 verses. Moses is calling upon the Hebrews to be captivated by how deeply God has embraced them as His people. He is their God, they are His people. This is the Lord, the God in the heavens above and on the earth below. There is no other. They have been adopted by Him, chosen out of the midst of many other nations. In our third reading, Matthew chapter 28, verses 16 to 20, in Matthew's gospel, the mountain is the height to which one goes up to meet God, who comes down to His people. How is it that they worship Jesus, whom they met there, but doubted at the same time? My personal interpretation is that they were feeling lost as to where they were to proceed as apostles from then on. Jesus clears that up by sending them out to make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the Trinitarian God, and teaching them to obey all that Jesus has commanded. To be a disciple of Christ means to always follow Christ who is present in our lives through the power of the Spirit. Baptism is the washing away of all that is not of God, so that we may belong to God wholly, so as to become holy. Then Jesus promises, "I am with you always until the end of the age." In Matthew's gospel, Jesus refers to the end, or the end of the age, or when the Son of Man will come, as a way of referring to the second coming, His second coming, as King and Judge of the world at the end of time. Although Jesus is not now present physically as He was before the Ascension, He is now present spiritually, empowering and directing us through the Holy Spirit to bring the world to Him. In our second reading, Romans chapter 8, verses 14 to 17, brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. The Holy Spirit Himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. Through the day, each day, we must choose to be led by our bodies. Thus, the influence of the world around us and the devil, or by the Holy Spirit. If we choose to follow the Spirit out of the power that the Spirit gives us to break free from the hold of all those forces that are not of the Spirit, we then become children of God. And if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ. It is not easy to break free from the forces of this world. To follow Christ will cause us suffering, but nonetheless lead us to also be glorified Him. May our dear Lord be my almighty and wondrous God be praised, adored, and worshipped as each day we follow Him through the power of the Spirit.